Hello, and welcome back to Kelio 60 Plays Metroid Prime. Last we left off, we finished the pirate hideout and got the gravity suit. This part, we will go get the plasma beam early, and then maybe, if there's still time, go after Thardus. So, to get the plasma beam early, you stand on this rock, and then jump over here, and jump on, I messed up. You jump on the stalactite, and then, with the small amount of room you have there, jump off the stalactite. L cancel and jump on D. And don't L cancel during this section. As far as I'm aware, this is only NTSU original copy of Prime. There we go. That's not the hard part. The hard part's still yet to come. As well as, you know, make sure you go after the right platform. No, I went after the right one. Probably was too short. That jump you're actually supposed to get normally.
I just missed it by a little hair.
In this set of these call spinners, I understand, because you're using the centrifugal forces physically. Because, what I did was the ghetto jump, where you somehow by jumping up against the wall, you get twice the height. Apparently, the Morphball doesn't have a gravity suit color. And then, if I remember correctly, you jump over here. And then I literally flung myself. Need to ghetto jump up to those blocks that have spireball tracks on them. This will be cut. There we go. And there we go. We're finally at the plasma game. Took us down it. But we got the plasma beam. So, yeah, we're gonna go in. If you were to play this game on hard mode now, I would suggest trying to see if you can get over here somehow, some way. Before Thardus, if you're playing this version. Thardus on hard actually is kind of hard. No, honestly, mainly because I ended up running out of missiles when fighting him in hard mode. That's supposed to be hard. I didn't die to him. I'd probably increase how hard he is. But, in the pirate base, it would teach you that the thermovisor can see conduits for the wave beam to hit. I know, and you can use it in this only in this room of Magnor to find 3 conduits to open doors. There is an energy tank here. Because it just, and slightly glitched programming, it didn't grab it, it still got killed by it.
It didn't grab the, here now. Surprisingly, I actually
scanned, hit the conduits in order. That was unintentional.
The timer just stops as soon as we get
the
energy tank. And this corridor will never be filled with lava ever again.
We'll still do Thardus, but gotta cut this piece out. Cause I need to save.
Actually, even with the mess ups, it only took me 15.
Well, with the fuck ups, it took me 15.
Thardus. The best part is, if you come into the boss room this way, you can scan him.
He doesn't actually activate
until you step over toward that spider ball rail, which is the normal entrance. So, and he still has an active hit box.
So, if you didn't realize that he doesn't activate till you brought towards that spider ball rail and just ran into him, I assume you could die. It's a mother brain in Super Metroid. Except, it stays there indefinitely.
Thank you. baseball bomb, get in front of him before he starts pulling out, take one out, pull apart. Know if the lightning actually does it. If it hit me, if it got really close to, if it's a one shot. He switches to the final phase. He's up the entire area. Because, honestly, if I'm being honest, any time I have issues with Thardus is in the fog phase. What you would normally do is either use the wave or charge beam, the normal charge beam, to expose each part and then fire super missiles into each spot. I think each part takes about 2 super missiles each. I think 4 in hard. That's why I would suggest, if you're playing on TSU version, get the, you might want the extra parts. Anyway, after being farted, we get the spider ball. And finally, the morph ball's blue. Oh. And if you're wondering, why is a certain thing not happened yet? I forgot. But honestly, we sit in the suit for so long after anyways. We'll be fine. So, I'm gonna get 2 more. We'll call it a part. And those 2 items are all going to be because we currently have access to the talking board. And both of you are going to die. So. Oh, and we get to meet an old friend. and here is a power bomb expansion. And here's her old friend. Now she is super weak. And yes, she died that quickly. Why can't I get the help? And true reason why it's rated teen. This game is rated teen. Instant incineration. You have until you beat the pirate hideout for the ice burrower. So if you forgot, oops. Well, I did one playthrough. Oh, thank you all for watching. Next time, we get two more items. It's mainly item pickup, because next part we get both the ice spreader and the wave buster. Thank you all for watching. Have a great day. See you next time.